On our big panel this evening, can Shinde avoid a comment on this? With me in the studio is Minhas Merchant, well-known columnist. Thank you very much. Also, Bharat Kumar Raut of the Shiv Sena joining us here. Sanjay Nirupam for staying back. Mahesh Jethmalani, senior advocate and leader who's been estranged from his own party of late. I don't know if he's making an official comeback soon. Thank you, Mahesh Jethmalani. Vinod Mehta, editorial chairman of Outlook. Naresh Gujral of the Shiromani Akali Dal. Hartosh Singh Bal, political editor of the Open Magazine. Sankarshan Thakur of the Telegraph and John Dayal, Secretary General of the All India Christian Council. Thank you very much, gentlemen, for joining us on this debate. May I begin by asking Mahesh Jethmalani. Mr. Jethmalani, first of all, it's nice to see you. I thought, you know, if Mr. Gadkari had been on, we would have liked to comment on your relationship with Mr. Gadkari and how that's fathoming out, but that's no longer relevant. Tell me, Mr. Mahesh Jethmalani.
I assure you.
I'm sure of that. Tell me, Mr. Jethmalani, besides this outrage about the use of a color for terror, is Mr. Shinde completely wrong? Because he might be talking not about a religion, but about the organizational links of the accused. You know what I'm talking about. So why muddy waters by making saffron appear to be about religion?
He's not talked about organizational links. He's talked about terror training camps. He's gone overboard. And if you ask me, it's a slur campaign on his part, and it's a slur campaign to divert attention against a pending petition in the Bombay High Court challenging the legality and constitutionality of the National Investigating Agency, a federal agency encroaching upon crimes committed in the state, in which
Mr. Jethmalani. Mr. Jethmalani.
One minute. I'm answering your question.
He's not talking about Hindu terror. He's talking about saffron terrorism. And my question to you, saffron terrorism may be a reference to the organizational links of the accused.
What do you mean?
Because of, I mean, whatever they are accused of, what are their links with the RSS? There have been links with the RSS in the past.
Well,
from the Samjhota to the Molegaon blast,
to
Mecca Masjid.
Those are all
Ajmer Sharif.
Which is exactly what I'm telling you, Arnav. You know, you can go on, you ad nauseum, but let me tell you, as far as most of these cases are concerned, there's a pending petition saying that the NIA is
So this outrage will not work. You can see the outrage is unjustified. You know, we are outraged. We will hit the streets. This is an affront on a religion. It may be a convenient first show by Rajnath Singh. But beyond the first day, first show by Rajnath Singh, where does it stand? My question goes to Sankarshan Thakur first. Sankarshan, do you agree with the political first day, first show of Rajnath Singh?
Listen, Arnab, you know theoretically, terrorism being attached to a religion or a color, I think, is wrong. Theoretically, I believe that. But when that idea is thrown into the crucible of reality and linkages are found, then names have to be named. And I don't know what facts there are with Mr. Shinde, because he has not bothered to sort of enlighten us on those facts. But if there are facts and there are established linkages, names have to be named. Saffron, the color, why should it be the copyright of one party? It's a color on the national flag. Hindus are not the preserve of one political party, for God's sake, in this country. Otherwise, this country would have been governed by people you and I know a long time ago. But if these linkages are found, then investigating agencies must investigate and prosecution must follow, as is happening in some cases.
No, but why is the Home Minister of India?
You named.
No, but why is the Home Minister of India drawing an imagery? There is a religious imagery, Sankarshan Thakur. Why are you in denial? The Home Minister of India is a poly. Why are you in denial? If everyone agrees terrorism is terrorism, agrees terrorism has no religion, why mention any color? Why did the Home Minister of India not say violet terrorism?
I began by saying
blue terrorism.
I began by saying, Arnab, that that theoretically I do not agree with these formulations.
But it's a political
problem. As I said, saffron is the color on our national flag, for God's sake.
No, you are digressing from the attempt to draw religious imagery. Sankar Shantak, you're not coming to terms.
So is green. 1 minute.
I am not a spokesman for the Congress
green,
party.
But you don't call.
Why are you treating me like
a
spokesman?
Yes, no, I'm not. I'm not.
The Congress party.
Sorry.
Yes, Mr. Jethmalani.
No. But so is green a part of the flag. But Mr. Shinde hasn't called jihadi terrorism green terrorism.
Precisely. Fair enough.
So when he has
that issue.
So when he's not talking about the Simi or the Indian Mujahideen as green terrorism, then why is he talking about saffron terrorism?
Exactly.
When it comes to these people, I mean,
I'm not from the Congress, Mr. Jethmalani, but can't you see how embarrassed the Congress is about that use?
No, embarrassment,
use
I don't see. We're getting counter reaction.
No, I can't. I honestly can't. I think it's a political move, and I think that the Congress, Digvijay Singh, has supported him. Many people have come out in favor of his statement. That's regrettable.
But the best thing to do is to avoid it. The BJP too and the Shiv Sena too. 1 minute. Bharat Kumar Rao, the BJP and the Shiv Sena too can avoid it. But it seems to me that the BJP is going hook, line and sinker for it instead of ignoring a comment that the Congress party and the government is itself embarrassed about. Why is the BJP latching on to it? Almost as if it is a political lifeline. Why?
Arnab, let me explain the whole thing to you. See, terror is a terror. It has no religion, it has no color. Agree on this point. Having said that, if the Home Minister of the nation, if he makes a point-blank comment about one color terrorism, that is saffron terrorism, then do you think this type of caustic comment should go unchallenged?
Why is the BJP going to town over it?
Of course, then who will go to town?
The BJP says we are going to lead protests 11 o'clock tomorrow morning. Sushma Swaraj leads protests on this.
Of course, this has to be challenged. This has to be challenged right there.
Is it being challenged or is it being inflated and politically hyped deliberately by the BJP because the BJP feels that I want to get in with BJP ally right now?
Let me complete my comment on this. The thing is that Union Home Minister has made a comment. If he says it is saffron terrorism by RSS and BJP, he is the Home Minister.
BJP.
He has National Investigation Agency, he has ATS, he has CBI, all the agencies under his control. If he has so many proofs, then it was his duty. Before making a public comment, he should have asked the agencies to investigate, and if he found proof, then he should have gone to the court or he should have gone to the police and done that. Why should he make a public statement on the forum his own party?
Well, you
say that we should ignore it. How can you ignore it? He is not Tom, Dick and Harry. He is the Home Minister. And anybody...
So what do you want him to do?
It has brought shame to all those who are concerned about issues like terrorism. We can't take terrorism lightly, as perhaps the Home Minister and the Congress party and some other people here.
Well, it appears to me, Mr. Bharat Kumar Rao, that the BJP, Shiv Sena and parties close to it, I don't know if the Shiromani Akali Dal, will try to milk this issue politically.
Where is the question of milking this issue?
As much as those who spoke about the phrase saffron terror, I'm getting
it. Where is the question of milking it? If at all it was a Union Home Minister, who is milking the issue?
For
no reason.
Is there no other issue that tomorrow the BJP has decided to carry out, begin a series of nationwide protests on this very issue?
Yes, should be. Another, I'm saying BJP is late. It should have started that day.
Vinod Mehta, why is this particular statement of the Home Minister, why is it not being immediately neutralized by the Congress party? If the Congress party wants, it can come and say, we don't believe in what the Home Minister
exactly.
said. He has said something wrong.
Yeah.
And the Home Minister can come and say, I said something wrong. Why is he not doing that?
Arnab, I think we should be quite categorical here and say that Mr. Shinde's remark was regrettable. It should not have been made. Saffron terror, Hindu terror are terms we don't want to use. And the Congress is in some damage limitation mode. But I have no hesitation in saying that it was an unfortunate and regrettable remark.
You see, Arnab, if we get into a situation where we talk of Hindu terror on one side and Muslim terror on the other side, and one party is supposed to support Hindu terror, the other party is supposed to support Muslim terror, we are getting into extremely dangerous territory.
I agree with you.
There is terror. There is terrorism. And I think this has been set point time and time again. I don't know why we get back to this meaningless debate when we all know that there is terrorism.
Sir, what,
but
no,
if the party political divide says this is your terrorism and this is my terrorism, then we are in very dangerous waters. Having said that, I think the 10 people who have been named by Mr. Shinde and who at some point, if not now, were involved with the RSS, well, that's a tricky one for the RSS. I think they would need to explain when and when they disassociated themselves. But Hindu terror, Muslim terror, Saffron terror, I categorically criticize and condemn these terms.
Precisely. And that's where, Mahesh Jethmalani, you are on the back foot. You can talk about Swami Asimanand. You cannot, so he was associated with the RSS wing, the Vanvasi Kalyan Ashram, from the 1990s to 2007. So you cannot have this.
Well, you know something.
It has been said by our panelists that the Home Minister has breached the limit.
You're being tendentious.
I am not.
You're being tendentious over here.
Mr. Jethmalani.
Nobody on the back foot. The matter is pending in court. There is not one person convicted of what is called Saffron terror, and the Home Minister is trying to subvert the course of justice by using the influence of his office to influence pending litigation. That is regrettable.
What I have said very clearly, Mr. Jethmalani, which you chose not to listen to, is that the Home Minister has clearly breached the limits by making this comparison about a political party running terror groups. You chose not to listen to that in your rhetorical flow, saying that I am being tendentious. I want to go across. I'll come back to you. Naresh Gujral. Why do you feel the BJP is latching on to this? Why do you think Rajnath Singh is determined to make a massive political issue of this by hitting the streets tomorrow?
Arnab, first of all, I think this is being done more by the Congress. We have been victims of this in the past. You would remember in the 80s, they dubbed every Sikh as a terrorist. And they then talked of Sikh terrorism. Today they are talking of Saffron terrorism. They are the ones who play politics. They are the ones who divide the nation. And they call themselves secular. I mean, this is shameful. I think what the Home Minister has said today is highly irresponsible. And he must apologize. And if the new BJP president is taking him head on, I commend him. After all, he must defend the Sangh Parivar, especially when they have not come out with any evidence.
Hartosh Singh Bal, should the Home Minister stop avoiding the cameras now?
Arnab, I think there's a lot of hypocrisy involved in this debate. In November this last year, November 9th, if I may be precise, I think your channel ran a program which said the return of Sikh terror. It was a two-part exclusive. The term Sikh terror, Islamic terror, has been used in this country for 25 years. Nobody understands it to mean that all Sikhs are terrorists or all Muslims are terrorists. It indicates that the religious ideology of those terrorists owes something to their perceived vision of a particular faith. And in exactly those terms, the term Hindu terror should apply here if we have been using earlier terms in those cases, because these 10 people have their affiliations in a particular kind of perverted ideology which they claim draws its roots from Hinduism. If you want, call it Hindutva terror. But suddenly that this country should wake up and all be affronted by the term Hindu terror while it has been conveniently using the term Sikh and Islamic terror is all sorts of nonsense. And your own channel has done
Let me make the point very clearly to you and unambiguously. Our reports there were about Khalistani groups trying to use. Exactly. So your point is correct to a limited extent.
The point here is one clear point.
There is no religious.
Please check. Are you justifying? There is a certain hypocrisy involved in this debate. Hartosh,
are you justifying the use of a religious prefix
terror?
then why do you say it's hypocritical?
It shouldn't have been done then, but suddenly to wake up. But
yes.
I'm saying suddenly to wake up to it now is a political usage.
Political usage by whom?
Absolutely.
By everybody who's getting involved in this debate. There is nothing. There's no big deal. Suddenly today the term Hindu terror has been used when we've been using similar terms in the past. Why are we making it an issue now?
No, but the, because the Union Home Minister of India...
Either
no, because the Union Home Minister of India...
He said Hindu terrorism.
Saffron
terrorism.
Yes, one second. Naresh Gujral is contradicting. Yes, Naresh Gujral, coming to you.
I said he has said saffron terrorism. And you all know that every time they say saffron terrorism, they are targeting the Sangh Parivar. So obviously Rajnath Singh has to react. What is wrong with that?
Why can't the Minhas Merchant, why can't the Home Minister just pull back and say it was a mistake?
Yeah, I think he should do that because what Mr. Shinde has said, I think is not only irresponsible, as a few panelists have mentioned, but I think it's a disservice to Indian secularism and our fight against terrorism, which is really where people are dying across the LOC and POK, etc. That is the real problem that we are faced with. And here we are diverting our country's attention, we are diverting our country's resources, and in what way? There's a tsunami of terrorism that confronts us. We're ignoring that. And there's a small wave of terror, admittedly, which is there and which should be tackled. But this tsunami is being ignored. So this is a great disservice that Mr. Shinde has done. And to answer your question directly,
nobody
yes,
is ignoring
we should
the tsunami.
Step back.
I don't think we should put a cap. Brush one kind of terror under the carpet in order to tackle another kind of terror.
I'm not asking anyone to brush anything under the carpet.
What kind of argument is that?
I'm not asking anyone to brush anything under the carpet, but I'm telling people that they should take note of what is a much greater threat to India than they are doing right now. That's not brushing anything under the carpet.
Why should anybody take it seriously and oppose it if
somebody comes out and says that I'm a terrorist? Do you think that I should take it lying down?
Absolutely.
Why should I take it lying down? I will oppose it, and all those who support me will oppose it. Same way, if he's saying it's a saffron terror, which is directly indicating attacking the RSS, the RSS man definitely...
I don't understand why this panel... Why this esteemed panel?
Found of people linked to the RSS and Hindu organizations who have been indulging in acts of terror.
Sankarshan Thakur, 1 minute. Sankarshan Thakur, would some deviant fringe member who claims that he fights for a religious ideology,
exactly,
but who has no business usurping anyone's religion?
Absolutely.
And claiming to fight on behalf of an ideology of a religion which that person truly does not understand the values of, why should there be an attempt
to prefix
a religion
Arna, what do you call that? What do you call the Taliban in Afghanistan, you call them Islamist terrorists, na? Do you think they are Islamic?
In our country, Sankarshan Thakur, with its diverse...
One minute. These are larger definitions.
What larger definitions?
It cannot be limited to this geography and that.
No, I'm asking you today. Sankarshan, tomorrow, 1 minute. God forbid tomorrow if there is a man from another religion.
But Arnab, I've given you an example.
Yes, Hartosh?
Where we have been using such terms.
Hartosh, I am
using such terms.
Hartosh,
and nobody has felt the need to object to it till then. Now,
okay, so the counter question coming from Hartosh is
usage which is prevalent in the country.
The counter question is, if the phrase Islamic terror is being used, then why is the phrase
Sikh terror. Let us not make it just about Islam and Hinduism. The term Sikh terror has been regularly used.
One minute, Hartosh Singhba. Let me make it categorical to you. Since you say this, 1 minute. We are talking here about terror of groups of people who are secessionists, and therefore that is groups that are pro-Khalistani groups claiming to represent Sikhism as much the interest of Sikhism as much as these fringe elements would claim to represent the tenets of Hinduism.
Arnab, are you saying that groups that are not using terror?
That's precisely my point, Arnab. That's precisely my point.
I am asking you that tomorrow, will any act of terror, will tomorrow if a man from X religion comes out and throws a bomb, will we say, it is X religion's bomb?
Exactly.
And how divisive will that be in our country?
Because it has been done in the past in this country.
No, sir. So you...
Arnab,
I don't...
It should have been done But I'm saying suddenly to wake up to it now is hypocrisy.
Let me tell you that in January 2011, Rahul Gandhi said, I have not come across any religion which preaches violence or killing of innocent people. In November 2008, Sonia Gandhi said terror has no religion, but some parties are trying to link the two. In December 2002, Sonia Gandhi said terrorism has no religion.
And observed in this country.
How does the logic change? In August 2010, the Congress Party completely, you know, contradicted this whole reference to saffron terror that had been made by the then Home Minister.
Such terminology, not the preserve of the Congress party or any other party.
How does the logic change in a pre-election year? John Dayal. John Dayal has been wanting to come in. John Dayal.
No, I have not been wanting to come in. As much as I've been feeling so left out of this August panel, I think Mr. Shinde is not the greatest exponent of Hindi or English, so we'll leave him for the moment. But for 20 years, the BJP has been demonizing Muslims in India by talking of Islamic terror. And it was the BJP again which was talking of Sikh terror throughout the early 80s. Let us not forget that. I mean, I have been a reporter of those times. No, the BJP, my dear sir. I was a reporter.
Congress fought the 1985 election
and the Congress.
And the BJP as well. Allow me to speak.
Sankarshan Thakur and Naresh Gujral, I request you to let Mr. John Dayal complete. I'll come to you, gentlemen.
And the Congress. Not just the Congress. But there's not an issue here. The issue is, if you were to go through contemporary BJP and RSS literature, if you monitor organizer and Pajade as early as last Sunday, they are talking of Islamic terror. As my friend said, thank God Prohit is not a Christian. Otherwise, he would have been labeled as a missionary fanatic.
No, so what is this competitive? What are we going to do? Competitive communalism? Will we have competitive communalism in our country?
I think Rajnath Singh does not have the guts to take on corruption as an issue of debate. He doesn't have a guts to take on the Verma Commission report as an issue of debate and 100 other issues. He has to pick on something which
is a soft issue.
Core constituency, which is not secular.
Okay, fine.
His core constituency is divisive. So his arguments are divisive.
So
blame lies more with Rajnath than with Shinde.
Counter argument coming in. Mahesh Jethmalani raises his hand. It's time for me to go to him. Gentlemen, this debate is going to continue for some time and therefore I will come back to everyone. Mahesh Jethmalani. An interesting line of thought from John Dayal. He says that this is the sort of core issue. Core issue for people like Rajnath Singh.
Yes.
He's picking on it.
I'll tell you why. First, let me quickly talk about John's argument. John's argument about Rajnath Singh can very easily be rebutted because there's been a frontal attack. And please note the words of the Home Minister. He has said that the BJP RSS have run terror camps. Even if he had said something else, if he had limited it to Hindu terror, and I'll come to that in a minute, it wouldn't have been that monstrous an assertion. But he has gone much, much further that the BJP RSS are running terror camps. Of course, they are bound to take up issue and pillory for him. They should. They should sue him and they should ask him for proof. That's point number one. As far as the terminology is concerned, branding particular forms of terrorism with a prefix, I agree with Hartosh. It has been used and it has been unfortunate. But there came a time when Chidambaram as Home Minister used the word saffron terror and he was pilloried. Since then, everybody has been very politically correct about not using religious prefixes or colors associated with particular religions in respect of any aspect of terrorism, whether it may emanate from a particular religious group or not. We've been careful because it's a sensitive issue and let's face it.
October 2008, is the BJP selectively blind? October 2008. A news report I have with me says 1 minute.
We are 1 minute.
Why don't you want me to quote October 2008?
You have a I am, but will you please let me finish? There's no point coming on your show if a man can't make it.
You don't allow other people to finish. I didn't interrupt you, John.
You're interrupting me. Now, all I'm saying is, as far as the religious prefix is concerned, since 2008, we've been politically correct. Why is the Home Minister suddenly now, in 2013, not only making a false allegation, why is he now referring to the, again, raising that ghost and calling it saffron?
I am saying that everyone, all political parties are jumping for this. Every political party is Bharat Kumar Rao. Digvijay Singh says, why did Rajnath Singh visit Sadhvi Pragya Thakur in jail? So the Congress party is, the BJP is, all sides are willingly jumping into this debate.
It is a reaction. Whatever Shiv Sena and BJP have done is a reaction, a natural reaction, automatic reaction. Nobody was talking about...
Talk about corruption.
Nobody was talking about color of terrorism so far. It is Sushil Kumar Shinde not only gave color.
So you made your point. One minute.
Also named a party.
No. The BJP made its point. It had a press conference. Get over with it. After that, when you start, Minhas Merchant, admit today the BJP is trying to stretch this politically. It's seeing a political lifeline here.
I don't think it's a lifeline. They're seeing a political advantage. But the point is that Shinde made this particular, I regard a disservice to India point. Because he wanted political advantage. And the reaction of the BJP is not, it's for political advantage. I don't think it's a lifeline that they are trying to grasp at. But, the whole thing is that Mr. Shinde should come out, say that this particular comment was wrong, that he did not mean that the BJP runs terror camps. I think that is such a ludicrous statement, that the BJP as a political party runs terrorist camps. Now, when you make a statement like that, your own credibility is in question.
Well, certainly it is, but I thought...
Now he has a responsibility to prove it. If he says that they are running terror camps, isn't it the Home Minister's responsibility?
So what do you want the Home Minister to do?
To prove it. If he says that, he knows that it's so, and if he keeps a blind eye on that, it is a crime then.
Prove it or withdraw. You don't think the comments of the Home Secretary yesterday suffice?
No. It has to go to the logical end. If he is leaving them just like a statement on the floor of his party, then it is a crime.
How can
the Home Minister knowing that it is the BJP RSS are running terrorist camp, then how can the Home Minister go home and sleep?
He has to open the bed. The other question, Hartosh Singh Bal, is of the advantage to Pakistan, gentlemen.
Exactly. That's the point.
Now, I have with me a press note of July 1st, 2009, U.S. Department of Treasury gives the personal particulars of four persons, a Pashtun born in Afghanistan, and a fourth person of unclear ethnicity originating from Karachi. The name of the second person here, Hartosh Singh Bal, and this question is to you in the context of advantage to Pakistan, is of a person called Arif Kashmani, a Pakistani national from Karachi. Arif Kashmani has been specifically named by the notification of the American government as involved in the suburban Mumbai train blast of July 2006 and the Samjhota Express blast of February 2007. It says that Arif Kashmani is the chief coordinator for LET dealing with outside organizations and in detail talks about his role in the Samjhota blast. It talks about how he received money from Dawood Ibrahim for the July 2006 bombing in Mumbai, how he provides financial and logistic support to the Al-Qaeda and its leaders. Now, my question to you, Hartosh Singh Bal, is this. Consider, has the Home Minister jumped the gun when you have American government linking a Pakistani national from Karachi to the Samjhota blast? Do you believe the Home Minister owes an explanation for jumping the gun? And do you think the charge is correct that he's given a helping hand to the Pakistani argument?
First of all, I think Mr. Shinde's statement was an extremely foolish statement, and we are all
But he's the Home Minister of India.
Of cases which are actually yes, absolutely, he's the Home Minister of India. He made an extremely foolish statement. He should step back from it. I have no problem saying that. And exactly, we are too hasty in prejudging cases which are actually pending in court.
No, precisely. So the American government says Huji is responsible for terror attacks, including the Hyderabad mosque attack, and the March 2007 Varanasi attack. Arif Kashmani, the chief coordinator of Lashkar-e-Toyba, is responsible for Samjhota attack. You know, the American government is talking in one direction and the Indian government is talking in another. Hartosh Singh Bal, I'm asking you again about the unfair advantage
to Pakistan.
I want to know what your and Sankarshan's take is on this.
Absolutely. The question here is not about the unfair advantage to Pakistan or not. The question
Why
is
not?
Who is the right person that we should pin down for this case, because we need to necessarily find out who really was behind these attacks. And that is very important to prevent future attacks. That
why not?
The most
no, why should, why should, why should,
that can only
why
be should we by not, asserting the...
Why should we not talk? No, no, Sankarshan, 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 1 minute.
Sankarshan, 1 minute.
It's a home minister.
Arnab, I think you are investing too much into one American. 1 minute, hold on. As Hartosh is saying, unless it is established by proper investigation, and this is something we always and serially fail at doing, how are we picking one American press note from 2009?
Not
and
one American press note.
These things have not been
not
proven.
Not a press note. U.S. government document into its own investigation. I am not in the business of picking up a newspaper article here and there and quoting it. I am picking up
the U.S. government document.
Do I understand from the premise of your question that we should trust the American investigations more than the Indian investigations?
No, my question to you is, you are completely aware.
I'm trying to understand your question because you seem to imply that the Americans have done a better job than the Indian investigations.
My question
is that what you mean to imply?
No, what I'm saying is
they may have. I'm not saying, but that is what you're trying to imply.
One second, Sankarshan.
Because the implications are clear.
No, Sankarshan.
All I'm saying is...
Sankarshan, please understand. Sankarshan and Hartosh, what I'm saying is...
Hold on.
Arnab,
you have made your point.
You have to get the point. The point is this. Okay. But limited point I'm making here, both of you gentlemen agree it's an ongoing investigation.
Thank you for calling us that.
Okay. I have nothing but regard for both of you. You both agree it's an ongoing investigation. I have proved... by quoting the U.S. Department of State, what it says, that they too believe it's an ongoing investigation. They are talking about a Pakistani hand in Samjhota, in Hyderabad mosque attack, in Varanasi attack, in the Bombay attacks. Exactly. And the Home Minister of India...
I have no evidence to believe either.
So is the Home Minister of India, is it an open and shut case? Why is it open and shut case for the Home Minister of India?
Yeah, sure.
It is not. It is not. Who said that? As Hartosh was saying, a Home Minister without any evidence cannot say that the principal opposition party, which has once been in government, twice been in government in this country, is running terror campaigns. Can you provide the proof?
We are getting some response.
That is not the issue at debate here. The issue is nomenclatures, isn't it?
Not the issue of debate here. One second, Mahesh Jethmalani.
It is not my position, Arna, please.
Mahesh Jethmalani.
It is not my position to sit here and defend what Mr. Shinde has said.
I am simply saying this, that each time there has been a statement such as this from the Indian side, there has been a clear attempt from the Pakistani side
to take advantage
of it.
Absolutely.
Whether in 2010, August, and what they said
now,
on the eve of
so
the foreign
sector. Just because the Pakistanis... Just because the Pakistanis will take advantage of it, we should brush all terror that happens or allegedly.
Okay, responses. One second. Sankarshan Thakur, Mahesh Jethmalani first. Take my round of reaction.
Just because
the Pakistanis may take advantage of it does not mean we brush it aside. Mahesh Jethmalani first. Coming to you, Mr. Raut, after that.
No, possibly me.
You know something. There is a. I just want to very quickly say that this issue is pending before a court. There are diametrically opposed versions, not only between American government investigations.
Absolutely.
And incidentally, that American resolution is also reflected in the UN resolution. Not only diametrically different versions of a same blast between what the Americans and the UN on the one hand have done and the Indian government on the other, but between different investigating agencies in India. You take the Malegaon blast 2006, the ATS Maharashtra and the CBI have said Malegaon 2006 are the handiwork of a group of semi-activists, including the CBI, when the Congress government has been in the center.
Today,
the NIA comes and tells us that it is some Hindu-Muslim mix.
Sankarshan.
All I'm saying
is... Sankarshan, one minute.
My limited point here is...
I want to understand one thing. I want to ask a limited question here. you made a point that if a home minister says, whether it is right or wrong, we do not know. I completely agree with Mahesh Jethmalani when he says these are ongoing investigations, there are conflicting reports, there are conflicting reports within agencies of government. But when you say that if we reveal something, and Pakistan will take advantage of it. So we should not reveal it.
I find it's not a question of a revelation.
The whole proposition
it is
totally
not,
ridiculous.
It is not.
I find it totally ridiculous.
It is not a question of a revelation.
I get a sense that there is a case being made here.
I am sorry. Of patriotic terror and unpatriotic terror. The question here is something an absolute truth.
Patriotic terror.
The question is, Vinod Mehta, is something an absolute truth? Because the Pakistanis choose to interpret something as an absolute truth. And isn't it true that on the eve of the foreign secretary level talks in February 2011, we know what the Pakistan office put out at that point of time about the Samjhota blasts? I don't know
where Pakistan has entered this debate anyhow.
Well, I mean, each time a statement like this has been made from the Indian side, you know...
We cannot look at India through the Pakistani perspective all the time.
Well, Shankar Sen, please understand, a person, a terrorist called Hafiz Saeed, who lacks the spine...
Oh,
well, 1 minute, please. Don't run it. Even Hafiz Saeed takes advantage of a comment such as that. And I don't think that can be brushed under the carpet.
Of course he will.
So the Home Minister should know the consequences of his remark. I want to get Vinod Mehta on this, on the whole issue of Pakistani groups picking up on this issue. It only broadens the debate on what the Home Minister said.
Arnab, obviously, if the Home Minister is saying that a political party is running terror camps and they are training terrorists, then you are providing fodder for Pakistan. There is no question about that. But Adnab, you know, please, for years we have been trying so hard to say that we are fighting terrorism. Your whole debate is to say that one party supports one kind of terrorism, the other party supports another kind of terrorism. This is extremely dangerous and extremely unfortunate. We should not get into this trap, however much they may want us to do so. If BJP is making a lot of noise about this, if it had been a political party,
his
statement was not made in innocence. He also made this statement because the Congress was trying to score political points over the RSS and the BJP.
Well, we seal the issue now.
Once we get into this party political game on terror, I think we are in very deep waters.
Well,
and please, we have enough problems in this country.
Naresh Gujral.
We have enough problems fighting terrorism. Let's not get into Hindu terror and Muslim terror.
Well,
Let's just fight terrorism.
I agree with you, Vinod Mehta. But if it had been a political party, it was one thing. In this case, it happens to be the Union Home Minister of India who has made such a comment. Naresh Gujral, I want your response to Vinod Mehta, who says, avoid the issue.
Arnab, I think Vinod is absolutely right. Because terrorism impacts the lives of every Indian, whether he's a Hindu or a Muslim or a Christian or a Sikh. And I think we should not politicize it. And I think the Home Minister, he made a faux pas. He should have the courage to take his words back and apologize.
So 1 minute. Is Rajnath Singh politicizing it?
Well, no, if you attack his party, what choice do you leave him?
So he's allowed to politicize it?
It's not a question of politicizing.
I want the BJP allies to take a position on it. Bharat Kumar Rao, have an even position.
Yeah, that's
you can't say don't politicize it and then say we are going to have agitations nationally on this.
The Home Minister makes a statement on his party forum against a principal opposition party. On that, if the party president makes a clarification or a statement or make another allegation, do you think he's politicizing? Who politicizes it first?
So it is competitive politicization.
Union Home Minister making a statement.
So that legitimizes that.
That is also unwarranted, uncalled for, unprovoked.
After that, if
somebody clarifies, the aggrieved party clarifies, you are saying that
your ally, the BJP, is treating it like a godsend.
No, whatever it is.
Is this a god? The answer Vinod Mehta's question point today. That this gets into very danger, because I said right on top of the news hour today, we'll seal this debate whether in the India of 2012 we need political parties doing competitive politics on terror. Tell me,
Nobody wants politics on terror, for God's sake. Nobody wants. But if I'm going beyond.
Nobody wants. But if Shinde hands us a little bit of a controversy,
the simple thing we can do. He is not only a congressman there. He is also Union Home Minister.
That point has been made.
If that is so, why can't we appeal, or anybody appeal, that Congress should distance itself from the statement. Sushil Kumar Shinde should come forward,
and then the BJP should call off the protest
and withdraw the statement, and then take the whatever punishment has to be taken.
John Dayal, withdrawal of the comment, clarification by the Congress party, 1 minute, and then a promise by all political parties that never again will we ever attach a religion or a color to terror. Doesn't that make sense to you?
You know, Shinde's statement is at best ludicrous, and at worst a slip of the tongue. You have to leave it at that.
But it is not a slip of the tongue.
The point is
Vinod, it a slip of the tongue?
Vinod is right. The discourse must shift from the demonizing of minorities in general and of all religious groups in particular, and come down to concrete issues.
Is it a slip of the tongue?
It's definitely not a slip of the tongue. I think it's a case of a forked tongue. You have the political establishment talking in a certain way, and then you have the government talking in a certain way. I think Rahul Gandhi should do.
Shinde is not an exponent of the English language, as you are.
I don't want you to interrupt me, because otherwise the conversation would be a waste of time for both of us. What Rahul Gandhi should do now is to clarify that what Mr. Shinde engaged in was not positive politics, which Rahul Gandhi is engendering. He is suggesting that there should be no negative politics. And what Mr. Shinde indulged in 2 days ago was the ultimate definition of negative politics. The least Rahul should do now is come out, clarify, and pull up Mr. Shinde.
No, so we are saying here that the question, biggest
but
question...
Perhaps Rahul should, but what steps
should
Rajnath take? He cannot be so aggressive on day one. Why is he being so excessively aggressive? What is this machismo that he's showing? What does the BJP want to tell the nation? Will they fight every inch of the way on issues that don't matter to the
issue that
really
matters,
that don't matter to the poor?
My question is very simple. I'm putting this to news our viewers. Why can't, on this issue, why can't Rahul Gandhi, and I may be a little naive, but so then are the people of this country. Mm-hmm. Why can't Rahul Gandhi and Rajnath Singh come on a platform and say that this position of 1 minute, Sankarshan, let me complete.
Of negative politics.
You see, we are talking about changing the system. I'm not cynical. I'm not cynical. I mean, why can't Rahul Gandhi and Rajnath say that this position,
thanks to your program,
this position is neither of the government, nor of the Congress, nor of the BJP, because with different voices coming from Congress and government, you know, some people will say, is this a good cop, bad cop routine? Is there a genuine divide on the matter? Is there a subtle attempt at polarizing?
It's not so subtle, Arnab.
Deliberately
aimed to polarize. This is the run-up to the 2014 election. We have entered the first phase of the political battle. We are going to see for
so
the
it's going to get worse.
Half. This will be the sum total so of what...
Of yes, course it's going it will to get worse.
Much worse.
It's going to get worse. Sankarshan?
Of course it is going to get worse. Of course it is going to get worse. And you know, I don't think if in the run-up to 2014, no matter how you try and how uncynical and believing you are of the goodness of people, Rajnath Singh and Rahul Gandhi are going to come and stand on one platform.
Well, I'm not saying that.
Let's not delude ourselves.
Not deluding ourselves. But then, you know, there can't be a slip between the cup and the lip. The stated position and the practical position of individuals must match. And asking for that congruence in our public life is I don't think it's being naive. It may be slightly idealistic. But then I think people of this country and the voters of this country can demand that idealism. Sankarshan, why should people live with the same divides that they have been through for the last 20 years?
Absolutely.
And if negative politics is to end, maybe Rahul Gandhi and Rajnath can start by sharing a stage on this issue.
Well, we can talk about this. We can talk about this in this studio, but nobody in India is interested at the moment in building a team of rivals.
A team of rivals on an issue such as terror, when both of them agree with their known positions?
Yeah.
You can take the known positions of Rahul Gandhi and Rajnath Singh and place it before them. I have Rajnath Singh's comment.
I do not think Arnab, I do not think what Mr. Shinde did was a slip of the tongue and or an innocent act. And I equally do not think what Mr. Rajnath Singh is doing is only genuine outpouring of protest at what he has been called. Both these are designed positions, and you will see much more of this on other issues happening in the run-up to, no matter how much positive politics people pay lip service to in the Congress party or wherever else.
Well, to all our viewers, I have just one question at the very end. You've heard this debate. My question to the Nuza viewers, I thank all my panelists, is simply this. If they say there is no religion that is attached to terror, if they say there is no color that is attached to terror or can ever be attached to terror, do you think it's time now for all politicians to walk the talk on that? Or is that asking for too much, even now, in 2013? Thank you very much for watching the News Hour tonight. I'll see you again tomorrow. Ladies and gentlemen, good night for tonight and goodbye.